So isolate scope is one of those things where you can read the docs for days and have no clue what they're talking about, but then someone shows it to you and you're like, oh, that was really easy. So we're going to kind of walk through isolate scope and why you need to use it with this kid directive. These kids are going to do chores. So this kid is going to be an element. So restrict E for element. And then he'll have a template which will look something like this. So it'll be an input with a type of text so you can tell him which chore to do. Ng model of chore. And then we'll just show the chore after, I guess. So if we add a kid here, we'll just say kid, and we show what's going on, you can say clean your room. And that's pretty simple. It's just that once we start having multiple kids, you start running into a lot of issues. So we tell one kid to clean his room, and then the rest of them receive that same message to clean the rooms because they're all sharing the same scope at this point. They're not isolated from each other in how the bindings and everything update. So what you need to do is pass in an object to the scope property there, and this will limit the scope to just being in one per kid, basically. So if we tell him to clean your room, and the next kid wash the dishes and take out the garbage, you can see that the binding still works, but it's limited to the individual directive that we created. And it's pretty obvious here why that's necessary. Now, where this can create some conflict is this breaks the interaction with the controllers that wrap around it, and invoking or binding to anything that's on the scope of that controller. So what that turns into is playing with some of these properties in the scope object. So let's create a chore controller and set up some things we'll want to interact with. So we'll just say chore controller, and we can log chore and then pass in the chore, and then alert. Can say chore is done. All right, so then from here, we'll just get rid of these other kids. We only need one kid to do chores. You understand why it needs to have isolate scope. We don't need to show them. So we can say when this kid is done, log chore. So we're going to set this up. Done to basically map to the log chore in the controller. Actually, let's make sure we set up the controller before I forget. Ng controller, chore controller, and we'll format this a little bit. So the kid done is going to map to this expression here. And how we're going to do that is by using this, we'll say done is the at sign for expression, sorry, and sign. I still get these mixed up if I'm not thinking about it. And sign for expression, and I'll go into more detail on the different expression value binding, what can go in here. And basically, what we can do now is create, we'll just do a div with a class of, let's break this up a little bit so it's understandable what's going on. Div with a class of button, and then ng click, it's going to invoke done. Now remember, this done is really mapped to whatever you pass into this done attribute. So right now it's log chore, and log chore is defined on the scope of the controller. So So I'm done. Oops. All right, so if you click I'm done, it's going to say undefined as done, and that's because we haven't passed in anything into done. And this does require a bit special syntax because of the nature of the beast here. You're going to pass an object with a named parameter of task, or sorry, chore. I'll just map that to chore. So the property of chore mapped to this value that we've already set up. And then in our index, got to make sure we have the value of, or the parameter of chore there. And then once we have this, we can say clean your room. And then click on I'm done, and we can say clean your room is done. So basically, if you see how this all kind of wires up, because we said this is an expression, that means that in here, this will map to this. And from there on out, anytime we invoke done, it's going to invoke this. And this is just the special object notation you need to use if you're going to pass in any parameters to it so that it can accept them here. So that's it for now. I'm going to go into more detail on the other options for scope and what they mean and how they work and the differences between them and when to use them in the next few videos.